this is an educational video for an assessment in the higher skills module for my degree, Sports Science and Outdoor Activities at Bangor University. The video will be focusing on two things, the draw stroke and the sculling draw. To move the canoe sideways or to turn it around if you're tandem. People who are working towards their two-star or just generally wanting to improve their canoeing skills could use this educational video.
To help promote your learning, red tape has been applied to certain areas. This will help to focus your attention during the demonstrations.
There are three key points to remember before you start paddling. Boat, body, and blade. If you don't get the first two right, then it'll be very difficult to execute a stroke correctly.
The boat. Try and get the correct trim in the boat by experimenting with where you position yourself in the canoe. Ideally, when paddling forward, the boat should be bow light, not like in this image here. And when paddling backwards, it should be stern light. If paddling solo, it is easier to heel the canoe over to the paddling side to reduce drag.
Next is your body position. The way your knees and body are aligned in the boat is important for the effectivity of the stroke. By kneeling in the canoe, you lower your centre of gravity, therefore increasing your stability in the canoe. Turn your body towards the side that you're going to be paddling on, pointing your knees at a 45 degree angle to the side. By doing this, it maximises your upper body trunk rotation, therefore allowing you access to the whole side of the canoe.
Try experimenting with where you sit.
It is also important to ensure that you have the correct size paddle for you. If you don't have the correct size paddle, strokes will not be as efficient and be made difficult for you. Also, when executing your strokes, make sure you use the whole of the blade. You can use them on side or cross deck. The draw stroke is a powerful stroke to move the canoe sideways. It can be used, for example, on a river if there's a rock coming up that you want to move out the way of. Place the blade into the water and pull the blade towards the boat. You can then either recover the blade by two ways, slicing it out along the side of the boat or pulling the blade towards the canoe, rotating your upper hand and slicing it back to the beginning position and pulling it again to the canoe.
Here's some demonstrations. Remember to look out for those two types of recovery.
Now the sculling draw. This is used to move the canoe sideways. The positioning is the same as the draw stroke. However, you do not pull the blade in towards the boat. You move the blade parallel to the central line of the canoe, slightly angling the blade, the leading blade, away from the boat.
When you perform the sculling draw, have a go at experimenting with where you're putting the blade in the water. See what different results you get. Also, try performing the stroke with your eyes closed.
Though I have mainly taught these strokes in blocks as separate elements, canoeing is a continuum of many strokes blended together. To help your learning, when practicing manoeuvres, it is important to try and merge the strokes together with different combinations, making the practice more random and specific to how you would use it on a journey. For example, a draw stroke followed by a forward stroke and a stern pry. Also, remember to learn bilaterally by changing the side you paddle on and performing cross-deck strokes regularly. Vary your practice by changing the speed you execute your strokes at and where you place your paddle. It will also help to improve your learning if you train with someone of a similar ability to you and the same gender.
A heart of gold, but it lost its pride. Beautiful veins and bloodshot eyes. I've seen your face in another light.